See a different focus?
Coming back off the bye, definitely a different focus. You know, the guys are refreshed. You know, I'm sure a lot of them were able to get away and, you know, focus on what they've done. And, you know, I saw a different focus and, you know, a lot of attention to detail.
Is everyone rejuvenated and refreshed even after this quick of a bye week?
Yeah, I think that, you know, I think it's mentally refreshed. You know, you get away and you come back and you come back with a new perspective. You know, a lot of guys, like I said, have probably went home and did different things. And, you know, it's just like coming back for a brand new season again.
When you looked at the film, what did you learn about your team through 3 weeks?
Through 3 weeks? You know, I thought that there were some ups and downs in there. Actually, I looked at some of the games, you know, the ones that we lost, and I thought some guys did some things that were pretty good, but they just didn't do them on a consistent basis. So there's the making of a good team there. We just have to make sure the guys learn how to do it on a consistent basis.
What message do you have for Will Ford as he enters this sort of running back carousel we've seen up till now?
Yeah, well, you know, he can stop the carousel. Those guys who are all in that role can stop the carousel as they continue to hold on the ball and do things well. Will he get a chance to play? I can't say at this time. You know, we have other backs in front of him right now at this time, but, you know, things can change between now and then.
Why was Hugh Charles released?
Well, he was one of those casualties when Will came available or knew that he would come available. But, you know, we're looking for a certain style thing. Hugh did a good job for us, but at the end of the day, I think it's early enough to where we can, you know, turn over until we find exactly what we want to have in a back.
Did the turnover have something to do with that release too?
Did the turnover have something to do with it? You know, that's all a part of it. You know, guys are given opportunities, they have to hang on to them. And when you lose that opportunity, sometimes it's a demotion and sometimes it's moving on to the next team.
When do you decide who starts on Saturday at running back and how do you decide? Is it a practice?
Well, a lot of it is, you know, health, practice, and a lot of different things. You know, maybe skill sets of what the game plan is that was put in. There's a lot of different factors that go into that.
How long are you going to go, Coach, when the fumble equals a benching? Is it as long as they hold on to the ball, or are you going to have to change that?
I mean, it doesn't matter either way, because if the ball's on the ground, you're not going to win too many games. So it doesn't matter whether they keep playing or not. You keep putting the ball on the ground. The number one determination in wins and losses is turnovers. So, you know, if we continue to hold on the ball and take away the ball, we'll end up in the plus column. It doesn't matter if we put six running backs in a game or seven. We just got to make sure we hold on to the ball.
What's Anthony Ellis' status heading into that game?
Anthony?
Yeah.
Oh, well, he's ready to go unless something happens between now and then. Yeah.
I don't know if you want to, but was Chris Getzlaf out there today?
Chris was out there today. He was out there in a limited, very limited role, but he was out there for a portion of practice.
What did you accomplish with a closed practice? Was this to roster moves? It was to have plays? Why would you close a practice this early in the season?
Well, you know, one is, you know, we're starting as a new season, and there's a lot of things that change, you know, whether it's the tempo style we practice. And whether it's day one, whether it's a lot of different things, I just thought that going forward, it gives us some time to seclude ourselves, make sure that we get everything where we want to be before, you know, it's actually opening out there.
What was the message for the team just coming back? I mean, the last time they were here, they, you know, they came off a tough loss against BC and then took a break. So what would you pass along to them just to get ready for the second half?
Well, new season. It's a brand new season. You know, last week's last week. Last season's last season. It's a brand new season. And like I said, there's always going to be losses. You know, I don't remember too many teams that have gone undefeated, so there's always going to be losses. And you just have to bounce back from them.
What kind of message did you have before you sent the guys in the bye week? Was it do your own thing? If you want to get away, get away. If you want to stay here and work out, work out?
Well, the bye week's the bye week, and that's what we used it for. And, you know, the guys, you know, they already had their mindset. Early in the season, once I give them the calendar, is, hey, this is the day you leave, this is the day you come back. What you do between then and there is up to you as long as you do some working out. And I thought the guys came back in good physical shape.
What's your degree of optimism regarding Getzlaf possibly playing on Saturday?
I'd hold my opinion on that one, you know, because he's the type of guy that, you know, Getty will take it all the way to the end and then say, I'm ready. You know, he'll build himself up. He's a tough individual, but hopefully we can get him back this week.
How is this year's bye week different than previous years for you?
I don't even recall the other ones. You know, it's a little bit different, but one, I think because it comes earlier and, you know, it gives you a chance to refocus and restart earlier than in midseason.